recently made a video called How to Create More Complex Nested Layouts with Elementor. I showed a method first where I create a section with the Add New Section button and then drag the Columns widget into that for further rows. I mentioned in the video that I didn't recommend this method because it can cause layout consistency issues, but I didn't really elaborate on why. I then went on to show you the method I actually recommend, which is dragging the Columns widget directly onto the Add New Section area. If you haven't seen that main video yet, the link to it is in the description on this one. A couple of people have just since asked me for more detail on what was so wrong with the first method I showed you, because I didn't really explain with a real world example. So here it is. Here's the basics of method one again. I'll add a new section, choose one column. If you choose anything else, you can't nest anything else in it anyway. So now I'll add in a heading. I'll give it a background color just so that you can see what's happening more clearly. This issue is definitely more evident when you can clearly see the outer boundaries of the columns or the elements inside the columns. You know, if the elements have got a background color or the columns have got images filling them up, it's much easier to see. Anyway, now I'm going to drag in a three column widget for the next row like I did in the main video. I'm going to add some headings in here too. It's just easy, it's quick. And I'm going to give those background colors as well. It's nothing to do with headings particularly. And at this stage, hopefully, you can see the issue. If you want a design that lines up properly, and in my experience, most designers do, then the edges of the content in the first column, the one directly in the outer section, they just don't align with the edges of the content in the inner or nested sections columns. And the reason, I mean, you can see here that the outer section itself is a column. Actually, well, the outer section contains one column with its own padding. Then the nested sections are inside that column, and then they also have padding applied. So they're pushed in further by compounded padding, so they don't line up. Now, if you use my recommended method, which is dragging the columns widget directly onto the Add New Section area, well, in one click, you've got a perfectly aligned nested section ready to go with no potential problems. I should mention, by the way, another way to get the exact same effect as this is if you create a one column section with Add New Section, click the Add New Section button, and then drag the columns widget in for the first row and the columns widget in for the second row, etc. That's absolutely fine as well. It's actually the same net result as my method. It's just a few more steps, which is why I like mine better. And just to make it really clear, here you see the section with the green headings was produced with a method that I don't recommend, and the section with the black headings was produced with my recommended method. Now, I do have some custom settings and tweaks that I add to all my Elementor projects, which avoids this and other kind of layout consistency issues completely. Just visit designbuildweb.co/get-custom-tweaks if you want them too. Here's what the previous finished page looks like now that I've got my custom tweaks applied. Notice how everything lines up perfectly at the left and right edges regardless. It doesn't matter if you don't use Generate Press like I do. The main Elementor tweaks is just some simple custom CSS, which applies no matter what theme you use. Hope that makes sense. Any questions? Drop me a comment and I'll be happy to help. Thanks very much.